Welcome to our season 10 closer. We're officially 10 years old. No pictures or videography or any of that. Which of those we've refrained from like texting or like prolonged conversations. We had I think we had a season ticket holder last weekend that was about ready to throw somebody a chatty cathy out of the audience. Speak up. If you are a season ticket holder, you may now renew your subscription. We only release 200 season subscriptions, and we allow our current subscribers to renew during the last show. If you are not a subscriber and you'd like to be one, we will put the rest of them on sale June 1st. At the rap party, and I'm not sure. So there's your information.
From take it off!
Only thing that we have after this, tell your friends we got a few seats left for tomorrow night. Saturday sold out, and then we go into the next month and we have Extreme Theater Games at 8 and 10 on First Friday. And then we start the whole thing over again. Check out the new season, it's going to be filled with. There's a lot of comedy in there, but of course, it's shots of somebody dies and there's a fight and then those other stuff. But it's funny. But anyway, thank you all for coming. Enjoy the show.
And he's all the way from the Yes. The union hears you, gentlemen.
Yeah, but what is our union doing about us?
Everything we can to get you back to work.
I got a kid up there. What am I supposed to tell him? That I used to be a foreman?
Hey, you were a great foreman, Jerry.
Yeah, tell that to Nate. And while you're at it, tell him there used to be a plant. He likes a good story.
Don't even get started.
That is the kind of attitude that won't get you anywhere. I have your checks. When I call your name, come up and get them. Bukowski, Jerry. Bukowski, Jerry. Now, instead of grousing about what the union can do for you, think about what you can do for yourself. That goes for all of you. What do you want?
What I want? That's easy, asshole. I want a job. I want to feel like a person instead of a slob. I want to wake up knowing where I'm gonna go. Not going nowhere, wandering the streets of Buffalo. Cause it's a slow town when you don't know where to go. I'll be wetting down the razor, then I figure what's the point? So I go into the living room, roll another joint, then lunch, then a beer, then sitting like an ape on the sofa with the hanky and the same old porno tape. And that's a big day when you're scrap. What I want, I'll tell you, jerky. I want a life, I want to feel like the husband instead of the wife. I want to get some sleep when I go to bed, instead of lying here digging through this garbage in my head. Cause it's a long night when you're scrapped. It's a long, long night when you're scrapped. Scrapped.
I'll tell you what I want. I want a place of my own. It could be a room even, just as long as it's mine.
I still don't know what I want. Somebody? I guess I'm lonely.
I'm lonely. I don't know what to do. I should get out.
A bar.
A party or two. I sure could use a friend.
Somebody.
Somebody new. But there's a horrifying moment when they ask you what you do. Hi, I'm Malcolm, a complete loser who still lives at home with his mother.
I have a big bucket of tisky, just across from my refrigerator, and vacuum my living room.
Hi, I'm Jerry Lakowski, 32, out of work, divorced, in debt up to my balls, and some serious dental work. If I don't come up with some money, they're not going to let me see my kid. I'm fed up, frustrated, angry, and oh yeah. Keeping you out too late.
When you have kids, Dave, it changes everything. There's nothing you wouldn't do for them. You should have had 10.
Why? You're having too much trouble with one?
Is this guy for real? Why do you look like that? It's a choice. Besides, they're all fairies, them Chippendales.
They are?
Yeah, real men don't look like that. They don't have the time. They look like you.
Oh, my sister saw them in Ithaca, and she said he was fabulous, and she's a lesbian.
You know who's going in there? What do they got that we don't?
Just about everything. Oh, $50.
$50. Where do those ladies get that kind of money?
Same way we used to. They work for it.
Yeah, but $50? Must be a lot of desperate women in Buffalo.
Why not? There's a lot of desperate men.
Come on, let's get drunk.
Ah, can't. Promised Georgie I'd have the dishes done before she got home.
Last week I caught you vacuuming. This is not a good trend, Davey.
You do housework.
I'm divorced. That's different. I have to. Where's Georgie?
In there.
With them strippers? You let her go?
Jerry, she organized the damn thing.
This is not good, Davey. All right, here's what we're going to do. We're gonna go in there, you're gonna haul her out of there, show her who wears the pants in the family.
It's ladies only. How are we gonna get in?
I'm up through the front door. Follow me.
Listen to him in there. It's like when the bills come back in the fourth quarter.
I don't know what all that screaming's about if they got the real thing waiting for them when they get home. You're still giving it to Georgie, aren't you?
Of course I am. What the hell do you think I'm
doing? Just hang us! Come on! Best friends ask stuff like that. That's what we do. So what's she doing in there anyways?
I don't know.
I'm telling you, you keep letting your wife do whatever she wants and you're gonna end up just like Pam and me.
Doesn't sound like you let Pam do much of anything.
Shut up. You don't know nothing about Pam and me. Go get her.
I'm going. You're not coming with me?
My wife ain't in there.
What happens if I get caught?
No big deal. I'll just castrate you.
That blood thing is just ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. Holy shit! It's my wife!
I wouldn't dare. It's the men's
room. Follow me. Here we go. Oh. What did I tell you? It's empty. Ladies, I would like to welcome you to the inner sanctum of the American male. Gentlemen, this is a hostile takeover. Who's got power? Who's got strength? Who's got the money in the woman world? Who feels freedom to let through tonight, honey, honey, in the woman's world? Back at home, I'm a beagle in the sleep, time is stirring up the batter.
Time! Bend over the dancing belly. That'll get novelty.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, my name's not Benno, and he's not a James.
What the hell are you doing here? It's ladies only.
Well, what are you? Pretty boy.
What the ladies wish you look like.
Yeah. Or what the we or what the ladies don't know you're not.
What you gonna say?
Real men!
Yeah, why?
Oh, don't worry, I will.
This is fine anyway.
You are!
There's one big zero.
Jesus, Jerry, what the hell did he do?
Took me for one of them.
Yeah, well, he took me for your manager. Hell, I'm the one who should take a swing at him.
Come on, don't let anyone mix it up.
No, no, stop. Listen, this is getting silly. We're a little emotional right now. We just found out what our wives thought of us. Well, my wife is ex.
You fucked the bag.
Yeah, that's sort of what they said. We've been out of job for 18 months. It gets to you after a while.
That's when my brother split down, but he didn't take it here anymore.
Ow! I'll just stay still.
You gonna live?
Oh, I'm fine. You're just lucky I didn't see you coming.
Oh, I know. I'm a very lucky girl. I got another show to do. This time, John Wayne.
Go figure.
Listen, who keeps working at a mall?
Yeah, that's what Jerry always says, except we're not working.
What's your brother doing in Albany anyways?
Working in a mall, honey.
Like a decent guy.
You hear that? He could be honey. Creep me out.
Thought it was kind of nice.
You cry at the Wheel of Fortune. Come on, let's get out of here. What the hell are you doing?
Ernie thought it was one of them Chippendales.
Shh. Do that again.
Am I turning you on to her?
Yeah. $50 a pop to see total strangers take their clothes off. Think of what they paid for the likes of you and me.
Yeah, nothing.
But we milked at the sight of us. A couple of local guys, bearing their all, and we're straight too. That, see all that? That could be us they're yelling for. Not somebody all perfect on a poster, but a real guy you could see walking down the streets of Buffalo.
Yeah, unemployed, scratching his ass and picking his nose.
You've got no imagination.
You're out of your mind. Guys like us are stripping.
You're out of work. Your pride is missing. They call you jerk, but you don't listen. You haven't got a pot to piss in, but you're a man. Your hands are rough. Your back is hairy. Your talk is tough. Your smell is scary. You're such a knot. You're not a fairy. Marvin, you're a man, and that's a bonus, cause when you're swinging in your cojones, you show them what, that's not a bonus, cause you're a beer drinking boo-boo and Chevy driving man. Don't do it to be the most talked about man in Buffalo. Don't do it for all the money you're going to bring in. Don't even do it so your best friend can keep seeing this kid, whom he loves more than life. Do it for yourself. Show yourself the stuff you're made of, Dave. Don't show me. Man.
cause he's a father. He wants his kid, he wants his life. He wants the na-na-na-na-na-na-na. He wants to be a man, a real man. Yes, I am, I've got to be, I've got to be a real man with a mission like you see on television. I'm a real deadline and you getting sole custody. That was not the agreement.
If you want joint custody, Jared, you're going to have to pay your share. $700 a month. That was the deal, and you've been in arrears since it started.
In case you haven't noticed, I'm on the unemployment line.
Then get a job. I'll give you a job.
$9.50 an hour at the Black Hole of fucking Calcutta? No thank you.
Jared, it's not the Black Hole of Calcutta. I don't think you'd stop using that kind of language when you're here.
Oh, Niagara Estates, I'm very impressed.
You're talking like a sailor.
Pam, have you ever met a sailor?
Teddy doesn't appreciate it either.
That wuss? Where is he?
Right inside.
I'm working on a stamp collection.
Fine, whatever. You want to go and play your little games, dear, you do that. But from now on, Nathan's going to have two parents.
Oh, you and your stud lover, Teddy?
The court will decide who Nathan's parents are.
No, they won't. He's yours and he's mine, and he's fuck all to do with them.
He said he doesn't even like staying at your place,
Jerry.
He said it's a mess and he's cold all the time.
Oh, we have fun. We have a good time. Where is he? Is he up in his room? Hey, Nathan! We have a good time, don't we, son?
Dear, don't.
Is he home? Nathan, tell him! Please. He can't hear me throw your double-glazed windows.
Actually, they're triple-glazed. You know, I want you to have your time with Nathan, but I want you to keep our agreement too, Jerry.
This is fucked! I'm his father!
So long, Jerry.
I'll see you, son, soon. Yelling at. We left him back at the 7-Eleven.
Unless you've got a better idea. I've only got 2 weeks to get the money or I lose you, buddy. Oh, that takes too long. I need a one-night killing.
Dad, please promise me you're not going to tell anybody what you're going to do. I mean anybody I know, okay?
You're not going to be ashamed of me, are you?
I'll never be ashamed of you.
That's my boy.
Well, that's embarrassing. I'm going to be like you.
Dave, our first day of training, and you look better already.
Save the sweet talk, Jerry. I ain't doing it. I'm not taking my clothes off in front of 1,000 women. I'm gonna get naked in front of Georgie. And we're married.
$50,000. We can make a lot of money.
You can make a lot of money. I'm keeping my pants on. I can't turn it because I'm a private dancer.
Come on, just think about all those luscious ladies lusting after you.
Give me a cigarette, I'm lusting for a cigarette. That's all I want.
No, come on. We only got another mile.
What? Another mile?
Come on.
There you go, Miss Lee. You son of a bitch. You bastard! Hey, man. Can I get a cigarette? I'm really lusting for a cigarette. Oh, thanks, man. Hey, you got a light? Oh, much splash.
Come on, Dave, we're almost there!
Hey, I recognize you. Were you at the plant before closed? Yeah, I thought so. You're on Jerry's floor. That's that son of a bitch up there. Well, how's it going, man? Nice talking to you too, asshole.
Come on! Quit hanging around with people. Get that out of your mouth. We're in training.
I don't know what's wrong with him. I mean, he's only got a job with the plant closed. They made him the night security guard. Holy shit!
Big ass rock or rope. I've got some quality rope.
what I said. And I will leave you swinging there, twitching like a fish as you crawl for air. I'll grab your feet, a pal of mine. I'll pull real hard and snap your spinal cord.
And drill me right through the eye with a 6-inch nail.
Oh, what'd he say?
I'm low on nails.
People are selfish,
you know, and another time. Now get this. I lay down in front of a steeple and I says to the guy to proceed, you know, business as usual, and just squash me like a buck.
That's a good way to go, Jared. The old buck squash.
You mean you guys think about killing yourselves too?
Every single day.
Well, what stops you?
And he tells me it would break his heart.
Oh, we can put a plastic bag over his head. That ought to be the trick.
That's such a whip suicide.
I stuck my finger in his socket one time and it hurt real bad. But it didn't kill me.
Now I'll have to stay out of this.
I've got a friend like Carol King. Was a Charlie Simon used to sing. I hope they get those two confused. But anyway,
rock
now, one good swing and I'm clean this clock forever and gravity to the work.
How's a man with a dog like me?
I got friends.
Oh,
looks heavy, Jared. Needs some help with that?
Nah, Dave. It ain't heavy. He's my friend.
He's my friend.
Come on, move on. See there,
time.
out with some friends?
You don't have any friends, Malcolm.
I do now.
Well, don't let me get in the way.
It won't happen again.
I thought you'd gone.
No.
You're gonna leave me here all day?
No. It's okay, Mom. It's okay.
Gotta love that man. He's like my personal man.
Hey there, Malcolm. Why don't you go dance with Mrs. Nichols while we talk with Miss Nichols?
Well, I really only know how to follow.
That's all right, Malcolm. I only know how to lead.
All right, what's going on here? Look, I know you don't like me, but hopefully you have some concern for my wife's feelings.
Look, we need your help. We want to learn how to dance. Help. Guys, I'm trying to help myself. I mean, it's sink or swim time, and I'm drowning.
Look, we're on a strip. We want you to teach us.
More like a buffalo version, you know, more realistic, more masculine. You know, one night only over Tony Giordano's, so we figured we could make $50,000.
Oh. But you guys can't dance.
Well, that's where you come in.
That would hurt everything.
That's so funny.
I can just see it now. The three stooges prancing around Buffalo with your willies hanging out. Let me ask you a question. What are you going to call yourself? The Dancing Ticks. You'll be that size, I'm sure. Bring your own telescope.
It's okay. We'll do it without you.
No, you won't. You won't do it at all.
Why not? Why the hell not?
Well, I'll tell you why. Because you're too thin and he's too fat. That one over there is way too stupid and you're all too ugly.
Mrs. Nichols!
Hey, no, okay? That'll kill him. My kid, don't kill me. Look, you guys don't know what it's like, what I'm going through. I mean, I used to be somebody.
Well, you know, so did Williamson Nichols.
I've got an MBA from the Wharton School of Business. I can't take this first thing that comes along, but you guys are kids. This is all a game to you. I can't go out and steal a car and go to jail like I see. I've got a standard of living. I've got responsibilities.
So do we. Tell him about Nate.
Mr. Nichols, Jerry's going to lose joint custody of his kid if he doesn't need this money. Now, you don't have any kids, but you do love the missus. And the way Jerry loves his kids, the way you love your missus, only even more.
Don't tell him that. He don't care.
$50,000
easy.
It's not even really my kind of dancing. It's just a bunch of ass wiggling. I mean, anybody.
If it was just a bunch of ass wiggling, we wouldn't need your help.
What if someone finds out? I've got a reputation to protect.
You've also got a stack of bills and a wife who likes to travel, Harold.
Harold.
That's okay. You can call me Jerry.
I'm just some of a bitch you take orders from.
Oh, sure, we know. You should have heard some of the names we had for you.
Yeah, Horrible Harold, Harold the Hitler.
So, how many guys you figure we need to do this right to make it look good?
Minimum six. I mean, that's, you know, unless you want to look at your skinny legs all night. There's a possibility. Ask him if he wants to strip.
You ask him.
That's what producers do, right? They ask people to take their clothes off.
Guys!
It's not really that hard. Just walk up to them and say, hey, you're a good looking guy. Me and my friends were putting on a show and just want to know, hey, you'd like to strip for us. See
what do you think about the ass on that guy over there?
I mean, I've seen way better. Look at me.
Guys, I feel bad. He's got four kids. Couldn't we just...
No. We can't. There has to be a lot of talent, Jerry.
Well, why don't we ask the piano player? Jeanette, what'd you think of?
No sense of rhythm. Sings flat, bad she paid. Other than that, I'd grab
it. We're running out of possibilities here.
Don't worry. When the right man walks through that door, you'll know it. He'll glimmer. The whole room will light up. I've seen it happen a thousand times. You audition for days. They're all dogs. You're ready to slit your wrist. And in walks Barbara Streisand.
Okay, who is this person?
I don't know, she just showed up, piano and all.
Besides, you're offering these boys more than a job. You're offering them hope. I have to tell you, my heart beat a little faster when I heard about this gig. I said to my husband, Lou Felcher, he had a small hit on Decca in 47. If you listen carefully, you can hear me tickling the ivories in the third chorus. I said, Lou, wake up. I'm tired of sitting and rocking, aren't you? We may be retired and living in Buffalo, which is probably an oxymoron, but I haven't milked my last cow yet. Some boys from the old mill are putting on a show. Send me my mail, babe. Okay, who's next? I'm ready to rock and roll.
All right. Figured I'd give it a try. Said amateur, and you don't get much more amateur than this. Hit it.
Hit what, sweetheart?
You knew the Heartbreak Hotel?
Honey, I wrote it. Do me a favor and try to keep up.
Man, they're every woman's fantasy.
Oh, boy,
his cold voice.
No!
So, horse, what can you do?
Well, there's the stomp, the bump, the twist. Now, my breakdancing days are probably over, but there's always the funky chicken.
Well, there you go, horse. One funky chicken, Jeanette.
So here we go.
Just remember, it's been a while and I got this dicey hip.
Tally-ho, horse, let's blow their minds.
When I was just a little nipper, daddy told me, son, that finger underneath your zipper can be lots of fun. When you get a little older, you'll understand that every woman in the world likes a big black man.
Plastered my bathroom.
If he sees me, he'll blow my cover.
Just keep your head down and it'll be all right.
So, what are you going to do for us, Mr. Gerard?
Oh, Ethan, please. You see, I've always wanted to be a dancer, but I can't dance. Singing remains my favorite movie. Donald O'Connor does this running up the wall thing. It's not really dancing, which is why I thought I could do it.
What running up the wall thing?
I'm Donald O'Connor.
Are you okay?
Fine, I just didn't get enough speed on that one. You know what? Let me try it again. I'll let you know when I'm ready. I'm ready.
You better just call 911.
Better in the movies. I'll get it right next time.
That's fine, Ethan.
It's just these walls are just so funny.
Yeah. That won't be necessary. So, let me ask you. You don't sing?
No.
And you don't dance?
No.
So, don't take this the wrong way, but just what the hell do you do?
Well, I thought maybe this.
You have no idea how exhausting unemployment can be.
You'll find a job, and they're still hiring them, aren't
they? It's women's work, baby.
Whatever makes you happy.
Guess what I'm going to dream about tonight, Harold? Those 2 weeks in Puerto Rico you promised me. Good night, honey.
Look at you, my life, my dream, my lady with the $80 slumber cream, the $100 haircuts, the novelty appliances we never use, and all those shoes you bought for when we go on the Alaska. I don't care, you're everything I want you, my world, my world, you're everything I need.
Anywhere you go, I'll follow.
Anywhere I'll follow you.
Anything you need, I'll give you.
Going on 4.
Yeah, 32 going on 10.
I still need a sixth man, Dave.
Ah, Jared.
You don't want a fat bastard like me. $50,000, we could make a lot of money.
Oh, man, what I wouldn't do for money like that. Now, season tickets for the Bills, something nice for Georgie.
Yeah, a vacuum cleaner.
No, but a new roof.
So why don't you do it? What's stopping you?
Common sense.
When have we ever let common sense stop us from anything? Come on. Just think, when Georgie sees you up there on that stage, right? With all the music, the lights, and everything going on, and you up there looking like...
Refrigerator Perry.
Oh, there you go, being all negative again. No, you up there looking like... John Travolta.
John Travolta. Hey, Georgie loves John Travolta. You think I can look like John Travolta?
You know, with the right moves and the right lighting, you could look better than John Travolta.
Fuck it. I'm in.
Yes! 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 Gentlemen, we got our sixth man.
Yeah! What's up, man? Hey.
Thank you.
think so.
Don't worry, Harold. They'll get it right this time. They laughed at the Wright brothers. They laughed at Columbus.
Now they're going to be laughing at us.
We've only been at it a week. Come on, we just need more practice.
No, it's my fault, boys.
It's nobody's fault.
I let you down. I did. I'm not a teacher. Yeah, but I can't even keep you guys in a straight fucking line.
For what?
Oh. You're right.
You know you want a hit? Jesus, it's like working with Lawrence Welk.
If we don't chicken out now, we're going to be the laughing stock of Buffalo. and Ethan's gonna have brain damage.
That's the spirit, Ethan. See, they always laugh at those people who say they're gonna go where nobody's gone before, but when they get there, it's nothing but R-E-S-P-E-C-T.
Somebody's been practicing.
Well, are we men or are we mice?
All right then. Let's get ladies and gentlemen here to sing, all right? All right. First things first, the bell.
The bell.
You gotta slowly unbuckle. And wait.
Tell you.
For what?
Jerry, this isn't a game. He's our son, but we're gonna lose him. What made me do this to you?
I'm not the enemy!
What a bitch.
Shut up, Steph.
What'd I say? Hey, what are you coming over? Goddamn, man.
Secret. Well, I don't, and I never do.
2 hours back.
Wow, this was like real gold.
Put that down, you'll break it.
Very la-ti-da, Harold.
These are the kind of walls I was talking about.
Hey, you got a beard?
No.
I don't. I must be crazy to let you guys rehearse here. Wasn't like we had much choice. Who knew that we were going to hire another security guard at the plant? And we're lucky we didn't get caught.
Yeah. All right, gentlemen. Today's the day. It's D-Day. Today we take our clothes off.
Do we have to?
Yes, we have to. If we can't take it off in front of each other, how are we going to do it in front of 1,000 women?
All of them?
Yes, all of them. When did you guys get to be so self-conscious? Come on. Just pretend it's like you're in a locker room.
Yeah.
Hey, Buckatinsky, how's the heck?
All right, just wait a second. All right, this is a nice neighborhood thing, in case you haven't noticed.
Come on, shirts off. No laughing, you bastards.
Dave, suck in your stomach.
I am. Sorry. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Well, don't.
I used to have a real job.
It wasn't so hard, was it?
Speak for yourself.
Come on, one small step for man, one enormous step for hot metal.
What's hot metal?
We are. Nathan came up with it. All right, now the pants. Gentlemen,
the day of reckoning is at hand.
You can say that again. Horse by name, a horse by nature, eh, horse?
Like this, I wish I was a black man.
You know what I mean, Russ?
Not really.
How about you guys start calling me Noah?
Should it be Horse?
Horse is a nickname, and I'm too old for a nickname.
Hey, you want to take a swim?
Not so fast! Horse is right. What's your hurry? Feel good about yourself. Enjoy the moment.
Hey, does
this anti-wrinkle cream work on men?
Has it worked on Vicky?
What the hell am I supposed to do with this thing?
I don't look too bad from the front, just don't turn sideways.
What? Dahlia has a weight problem. She wraps herself in saran wrap.
Saran wrap? Oh my, turkey leg saran wrap yourself!
Fat David is a feminist issue.
Yeah, what does that mean when you're a guy?
It means fatter, thin, you're beautiful.
Do you believe that?
No, I don't. I don't even know what he does. You are what you look like. Ask Vicky. See, this is what we're supposed to look like, men and women.
Holy Mary, Mother of God! Dave, check this out! God, this is better than Playboy.
But who looks like that in real life?
This one does?
Jesus Christ, Jerry's the picture of a magazine.
It's good enough for me. Take a look at this girl! That's everything I like. She's got the face, she's got the waist, she's got the legs.
No, her tits are too big.
Are you crazy? Bodacious fun bags are a must. If I gotta be C or B or better, they got to pose a threat to the slender. Ow!
She has some irredeemable flaws. I give her a 6. Now there's a 10.
You call that a 10?
Based on the boot tag. She got a butt like a battleship. I don't need to look above the hip. She got that show kind of ass. You can display your tchotchkes, your collectibles on there. Baby's got back, and that's a back. You can bark the wide track, Monty, and that track.
Wait, we normally talk about them?
We're in trouble. You just said her tits were too big. What if they say the same thing about our dicks?
I'm being serious.
big.
My tits are not too big! And besides, I wasn't talking about her personality. I'm sure she's a very fine young woman.
Yeah, well, they're not going to be talking about your personality either when you're standing up there in all your masculine glory. Which is lucky enough for you because you're basically a bastard. And guys, anti-wrinkle cream there may be, but anti-fat bastard cream, there ain't.
Thank you.
go cuddle and we don't... What is going on? I'm your wife. You gotta talk to me.
Are you still hiring out at Walmart, man?
Oh, that nun's face when you ran across the playground.
I thought she was gonna paint eyelashes for
what? She is! Something's wrong. Mom? Mom? Ethan, to help his mother! Mom!
Are you alone?
Thank you. looked pathetic. I almost didn't recognize you in that uniform.
Don't rub it in.
Your costume's still waiting for if you change your mind about Sunday.
I can't, Jerry. I promised George I'd get this thing at Walmart a real try. Don't you think I want to be there with you and the guys on the big night?
There's a word for guys like you, and it ain't a pretty one.
I love my wife.
We were supposed to be in this together, to the end, like always, best friends.
We still are.
I always knew when the chips were down that we'd wimp out at Walmart.
Go to hell.
What do you want me to say, you fat bastard?
Don't ever call me a fat bastard again, all right? Ever.
Okay. I need to get back to work. I came too late. I don't want to get fired on my first day.
Me. What do you?
look at me, Harold.
Hold me tonight.
Honey, don't you understand?
Why are you crying, son, to me? Twice as bright.
I never let you.
Here we are, edge of the cliff, Butch Cassidy and the Sun. What the hell's wrong?
wrong with either?
I can't do it. I can't go out there.
What do you mean you can't go out there? This was your idea.
They're going to laugh at us.
Yeah, I don't blame them. It's pretty damn funny.
Jerry Lukowski.
Well, then give him Jerry Lukowski.
And let a bunch of strange women see me naked?
That's kind of the idea in a strip club.
Hey, guys. It's places. Lukowski, you're either in or out.
I'm out. If he's out, then I'm not going to Full Monty.
Neither am I.
I don't mind either, Full Monty.
Who asked you, Ron Jared?
Listen, hey, listen. If one of us doesn't go, none of us goes. We'll give them one hell of a show and leave the rest up to their imagination. See you around, Jerry.
Your money back.
I'm not talking about money, I'm talking about you.
all grown up on me.
Dad, just wants no white friends.
Alright, honey, what is it?
This guy's going to be a real fish boy. A loser.
Who are you calling a loser?
My father. He promised my father. He said he was going to have all that kids. This is it. Everybody we know is out there.
You think I'm a great father?